Jain students, so today we are going to study chapter number 5, the Ailing Planet, and we will move forward from where we had left in school during physical classes. So first of all, I am going to share the story with you on your screen. Please wait a minute. Yes, now students, you can see that page number 45 and two paragraph of page number 5 have already been explained. Now we are going to study from paragraph number 3. Now let us see that what author says here. Author says that the concept of sustainable development was popularized in 1987 by World Commission on Environment and Development. Now the author Naini Palkewala says that there is a dire need of sustainable development, and sustainable development was became popular in 1987 by World Commission on Environment and Development. And in its report, it defined the idea as development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs. And here, World Commission on Environment and Development says, defined as given the definition of the sustainable development. So it is very important, you can also underline that the sustainable development is the development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of the future generation to meet their needs. Definitely our natural resources of the earth is present for our utilization of present generation, but it is also our responsibility to sustain it, to maintain it for future generations, so that future generation should not compromise with the ability to meet their needs. They can also meet their needs. They can also fulfill their demands of the natural resources like fishery, forest, grasslands, and croplands. So that's why it is our responsibility. It is the responsibility of the present generation to maintain the sustainable development of the natural resources. That is, without stripping the natural world of resources. And here poet means that the development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs means without stripping, means without removing the natural world of resources future generations would need. Means as we require the natural resources like fisheries, forests, grasslands, and croplands, and after present generation, future generation also require those things. So we should not exploit only our natural resources, rather it is also our duty to maintain it, to sustain it for the future generation. So please, you can underline that what is the sustainable development. That is one of the important question. Now let us see the next question, means next paragraph. In the zoo at Lusaka, Zambia, in the zoo Lusaka, Zambia, means there is there is a zoo at Lusaka in Zambia, and there is a cage where the notice reads, and there is a cage, a big cage kept inside the zoo, and where the notice reads, and there is a notice before when we enter into the zoo, then we find that there is a big cage, and before the cage there is a notice, and in that notice it is written that the world's most dangerous animal, means notice is about the most dangerous animal, means there is a most dangerous animal inside the cage. But inside the cage there is no animal but a mirror where you see yourself. But when we enter into the cage to see that, definitely that we are curious to know that who is, means are, what is the most dangerous animal of the world. And but when we enter into the cage, then we find that there is no animal but a mirror. Only a mirror is kept there where you see yourself, where you can see your face, means we people can see our faces. It means that who is the most dangerous animal? It is we human being who is the most dangerous animal, means that we are the cause of all kind of destruction of the environment, destruction of the earth greenery. If earth seems to be ailing, seems to be a patient, so only we human being is responsible for that. Now further author says that thanks to the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries, a new awareness has now dawned upon the most dangerous animal in the world. Thanks to the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries. Now author says that different countries number of agencies are working to improve the condition of the environment in different countries, and they are also continuously creating the awareness among the people to maintain the sustainable development. And because of their efforts, a new awareness has now dawned upon the most dangerous animal. Most dangerous animal means we human being. And because of the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries, a new awareness has been created among the people, among the human being in the world. And he has realized, and now here, that man has realized the wisdom of shifting from a system based on domination to one based on partnership. And because of the great efforts of these number of agencies, man has started realizing the wisdom of shifting from system based on domination. Because earlier that people were thinking they were dominating the nature, they were thinking that the natural resources for their own use only, they can use it, they can destroy it the way they want. But now that new awareness has been created, and now they have realized that they should not dominate the natural resources, they should not dominate the nature. Instead, they should play the role as a partner. They should instead of domination, their participate should, they should become the partner, means they should not only utilize the natural resources, rather it is also their responsibility to maintain the nature for future generation. This kind of awareness has been created by the efforts of the number of agencies in different countries, and which is a good sign for the improvement of the environmental condition of the earth. And further, the author says that scientists have cataloged about 1.4 million living species with which mankind shares the earth. Now further, the author says that scientists have made a list of about 1.4 million living species, group of animals. They have made the list of 1.4 million living species, means group of animals, which with which that mankind shares the earth. And with the 1.4 million species, that human being, means we share the earth, means on this earth we don't have human being, don't have the sole right. Rather, those living species, 1.4 million living species, have also the same right to share the earth, to utilize the natural resources, as we human being. But further, author says that estimates vary widely, but there is a huge difference in this data presented. And because the estimates vary widely, because as regards the still uncatalogued living species, because the number of uncatalogued species are far more than the data presented. And biologists reckon that about 3 to 100 million other living species still languish unnamed in ignominious darkness. And because that, further the author says that according to the biologists think that about 3 to 100 million other living species are still living on the earth, but they are languished, they are forced, languish means they are forced to live unnamed, means they have not been cataloged, they have not been identified till now, they had not been given any name, and they are forced to live in ignominious darkness, means humiliating darkness, because they have not been given any name, they have not been given any name, and they have even not been identified, but still they are sharing the earth. They are forced to live in humiliating darkness, means that on the earth that we human being don't have only the sole right, rather they also have the same right, these animals, these living species have also the same right to share the earth as we human being have. Now let us see that what poet says in next paragraph. The poet says that one of the early international commissions which dealt with inter alia means among other things, one of the early internet, there was an early international commissions, and which was dealing among other things with the question of ecology and environment, was the Brand Commission. There was a Brand Commission which was dealing with the along with the ecology and environment. He was dealing with other things also, and which had a distinguished Indian as one of its members, Mr. L.K. Jha. And in this Brand Commission there was one of the very distinguished Indian who was also the member of this Brand Commission, and he is Mr. L.K. Jha. And the first brand report raised the question, and first brand report had raised the question, means they have done extensive observation of the deteriorating condition of the environment, And then after observing, they have prepared their report, and according to the Brand Commission's report, they raised a very serious question before us. And that question is, remember student, this question is very important for you to remember, because long answer type questions can also be asked which is based on this statement. And the Brand Commission in his report raised the question that are we to leave our successors a scorch planet of advancing deserts, impoverished landscapes and ailing environment? Means it is a big question before us, that they raise that RV means the condition, the way the health condition of the earth has deteriorated, had declined, and by that they raise the question that are we going to leave our successors, our coming generation, a scorched planet, a dry planet, because that natural resources have been overexploited, means the natural resources conditions are very bad on the earth. And that's why they raised the question that are we going to leave for our successors a dry planet. Scorch planet means a dry planet which comprises the deserts, impoverished landscape, you know, poor landscapes, poor scenery, means without greenery, the scene without greenery, and ailing environment, and our environment will be ailing, will be diseased, will be ill, means we are going to leave a dry planet, a dry earth for our coming generation if the exploitation of the natural resources will be continued as it is. So that's why means he had raised a big question to take immediate step to improve the environmental condition and natural resources of the earth immediately. And in next paragraph, the author says that Mr. Lester R. Brown, in his thought book Mr. Lester R. Brown, an environmentalist who had written a book, and in his thoughtful book The Global Economic Prospect, he highlighted that the earth's principal biological systems are four: fisheries, forests, grasslands and croplands. Now remember students, this is very important, because these are the four principal biological systems, four main natural resources of the earth: fisheries, forest, grasslands and croplands. And why they are the principal biological systems? Because they form the foundation of the global economic system. They are the foundation. They are these four natural resources: fisheries, croplands, grasslands and forest are the foundation of the global economic system. Means world's economic system is mainly world economic system is based on these four natural resources. And in addition to supplying our food, now further the author says that in addition to supply our food, these four systems provide virtually all the raw materials. Means these four natural resources not only provide us food, but apart from that, these four systems provide virtually all the raw materials. Almost virtually means almost all the raw materials. They not only provide food, definitely they provide food to us, but apart from that, they also provide almost all the raw materials for industry except minerals and petroleum derived synthetics. except minerals and petroleum-derived synthetics, means they provide almost all the raw materials for the industry. That's why they are the principal, they are the foundation of the global economic system. In large areas of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level. And what is this unsustainable level? Remember, students, please underline. An unsustainable level is a point where their productivity is being impaired, and that after the observation, it is revealed that in large areas of the world, in big areas of the world, human's utilization of these natural resources have reached to an unsustainable level. Unsustainable level means they have reached to a point where their productivity is being impaired, being damaged. Their productivity is being damaged means that, for example, we can take that earlier that we had, you know, a number of trees, but almost all those trees have been cut down and no new trees have been planted, and because of that area, specific area, has become almost treeless. Then what will happen to the future generation? If we will finish our natural resources, then what will happen with the coming generation? They will not have any natural resources left to use, and that's why there is need of sustainable development. And when our natural resources will reach to an unsustainable level, then what will happen? That condition will be very critical, because that when this happens, fisheries will be collapsed, and then forest fisheries will be collapsed, a large number of population of the world will be affected, because that fishery is a great source of food and it is also a rich source of protein for the people, and they will be deprived of the food and protein and natural protein, and the forests disappear, and then forests are also being disappeared rapidly. Grasslands are converted into barren wastelands. Grasslands will also turn into the barren wastelands, and croplands deteriorate, and croplands condition will also be declined. Then what will happen? What will be its effect? Its effect will be very dangerous for us, as in a protein conscious and protein hungry world, overfishing is common every day. And now further, the author has given an example that we are protein conscious, we are protein hungry people. Protein hungry people are there in the world, and overfishing is very common for protein, that overfishing is being done across the world. And in poor countries, now the author has given another example to show the deteriorating condition of the earth and natural resources. And further, author says that in poor countries, local forests are being decimated. Means local forests are being destroyed. Local forests are being destroyed in poor countries, in order to procure firewood for cooking, because they need firewood for cooking. In order to procure means in order to get firewood for cooking, that local forest are being destroyed. And there is so many, means it is quite harmful for the country, for the people, if local forest will be destroyed. And in some places, further the author says that in some places firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot now costs more than what goes inside it. Now remember students, this statement is very important. Here the author means to say that what goes under the pot means that grain, the food which we cook inside the pot, what goes under the pot means the fuel, the firewood, the fuel cost more than what goes inside it, means what is being cooked, means the firewood, even the fuel, has become more expensive than the food grains in some of the poor countries. The condition is very critical in this way. And since the tropical forest is, in the words of Dr. Myers, the powerhouse of evolution, and Dr. Meyer had given, according to the Dr. Myers said that the powerhouse of evolution, tropical forest is the powerhouse of evolution, tropical forest is the powerhouse of development. But if this tropical forest will be used for destroyed for firewood, then that country can never do any kind of progress. And several species of life face extinction as a result of its destruction, and it has many harmful effects, adverse effects, because that if tropical forest will be finished, will be destroyed, then it will affect species of life, you know, several species of life will be affected, several, you know, group of animals who live into it, they will be disturbed, they will face the extinction, they will disappear from the earth, as they don't have any shelter, means they will be deprived of their natural habitat, and in this way that whole eco balance will be disturbed. So that's why the poet here that highlights the need of the sustainable development to protect and preserve our natural resources. It is very important, otherwise that our coming generation, future generation, will have to face a lot of problem because of that. That's all for today, students, and the remaining paragraphs we will study hopefully in the classroom during physical classes. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a nice day.